everybody, this is Mr. Bobby's Models, aka Amy, and you might notice that I have a different background today. That's because I'm in a different room. I thought I would film in here because the lighting is better in this room than it is in my bedroom where I normally film stuff. So today I have a box, and it's a very, very special box. This is directly from Peterstone in the US. And this particular model is extra, extra special because my boyfriend bought her for me. My boyfriend was nice enough to buy this model for me when I saw her on the website and fell in love with her and I started going crazy over her. And then he was like, bought her, surprise! Let's unbox her, yay! Let me know what you think of this backdrop. I actually think it's quite cool for filming. Just take that. Okay, so we have the order slip, and it looks like he got her in glass. He wouldn't tell me what finish he got her in, but I looked at the price of his invoice and it was really expensive and I couldn't figure out why. But that would explain it. That would explain. So yes, I have a new glossy piece. Let's see if we can find her without making too much of a mess. Oh no, I don't want to get stuff everywhere. I managed to not make too much of a mess, so that's good. Let's put the box aside. So she's in here, and as you can tell, she's quite a little one. I wonder if you can guess what mold it is by the size of this packaging. She is a traditional or stone scale model. So her tag is on the front. If you don't know, most Peterstones will come with a little ID tag. So just as an example, this is this model's tag. So you can see her name is Dolly. This is her price. It says oak at the bottom here and the date that she was produced. Enough about the tag though, let's open her. Ooh, can you see? Oh, oh my god. Oh my gosh. Little baby. This is Dolly. She's a one of a kind. She's painted by Ellen Robbins, who is a newer painter at Peterstone. I think this is the first piece I've had by her. I believe she only started at either the very end of 2020 or the start of 2021. So she's a super new painter. And wow, I'm impressed. I'm really impressed. So this girl is a little dappled buckskin baby. Oh my goodness. I will give you guys close-ups because you're not going to see the level of detail on her from this distance. I find sometimes that Peterstone's photos don't show colour very accurately, and the same for Briar too. I find that quite often their colours are way nicer in person. I don't know whether it's to do with the editing or the lighting in their studio. I'm not sure. She looked much more orange and she looked darker on the Peterstone website. But in real life, she is just like the most beautiful colour I've ever seen. So I'm really, really excited about that. And she's just... woo! She does not have a signature on her belly. And I don't know whether this is because Ellen doesn't sign the models yet. I'm not entirely sure, actually. Maybe I'll ask Peterstone on the Facebook page. Because I always wonder, because some models are signed and some models aren't with Peterstone. And I can never figure out why they sign some and why they don't sign others. But anyway, it doesn't really matter, because I know who painted her and I have her page saved on the Stonehorse reference website, just in case I ever forget or lose her name tag. All right, I'm going to give you a close-up now. She is the most... She's the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. I love her.
Boop the snoot. Boop the snoot. Boop.
Okay, so it's time to give you some close-ups of Dolly. I'm going to mention, I'm going to rename her to Jaeger or Jaegermeister. Reason being is because, like I said, my very, very lovely boyfriend Jake bought her for me and paid for her, which is just so incredibly kind and I'm so grateful. And his absolute favourite drink is Jaegermeister. And I thought since he bought her, I had best give her a name that he would appreciate. So yeah, this is Jaeger. She has the most stunning colouring. I don't know if you can tell on this camera, but she has a slightly dappled kind of effect going on. I'm not sure if it's supposed to be dapples or just a slightly uneven foal coat. But it looks incredible in real life. It's kind of not picking up on the camera, kind of is a little bit, but it looks stunning. It is awesome. And if we take a look at her socks, she has two hind socks, one slightly higher sock and then a little low sock. And she has these lovely dark points on her legs. One of the reasons why I really liked her was because normally on a buckskin model, the whole lower leg is dark. Whereas on her, it is still light, but it still has those realistic dark points. And I really, really like that. She has the sweetest little face I've ever seen in my entire life. And really unique markings. I love this little leg marking thing going on here. And she has this little marking on her front too, which is super cool. Just makes her a little bit more interesting. And look at those little knees and fetlocks. So sweet. And here is the face. It is the cutest thing. So she has this like wide blaze going on and it kind of wraps around her face at points on either side. And you can see there's a little bit of pinking there too because it goes almost onto her nose. And then she has a little lip spot. And this is the funniest angle for her. It's so funny. I love it. And she has really nice ears, lovely dark points going on there. Moving on to her other side. She has brown eyes. I don't know if I mentioned that, but they are super cute. And here's an overview on this side. You can really see this kind of like dappling and variation in coat color on this side. That's kind of what she looks like in real life all over. It is crazy. It's very unique. I love it. It's a really nice touch. And it's the kind of touch that I always really appreciate with one of a kinds. You know, the artists and painters can put these little twists on oaks that they can't really do on larger runs or limited edition models. Yeah, stunning colour. I really like her markings on this side as well. Again, she has these little markings at the very top of her leg. And they just add so much detail to her and I really appreciate them. And then of course we have the little foal booty. Little black tips to the ears and of course a dark mane and tail. And then lastly, I'll very quickly show you the bottom of her. Nothing too exciting going on with her down here. And like I said earlier, she's not signed, so she's just pretty plain down here. But I very rarely lie my models down and look at their bellies. So that is absolutely fine with me. She has to be one of my favourite stones in my collection now. I have no words. Thank you so much to my boyfriend Jake for buying her for me. She is literally the best thing ever. Alright guys, so that is going to be the end of today's video. I really hope that you enjoyed watching me unbox this little Foal. She is just the most adorable thing ever. I do actually have another model on this mold, so she is going to join her. They're going to sit together on my shelves. I will take pictures, I will take pictures of her and post them on my Instagram. So if you would like to see her in pictures, you can follow me at Mr. Bobby's Models on Instagram. I also have a lot of Peter Stones now, and the collection is ever growing. So yeah, make sure you follow me on Instagram to keep up to date with all of my gorgeous Peter Stone models. I plan to get more videos out to you guys in the future, but in the meantime, have a great week and I'll see you soon. Goodbye!